Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be something I've never ever done before on my channel. It's something very, very Kelly Gooch inspired. And if you know, and if you've been watching my videos for a while, you would know that Kelly Gooch is one of my favorite American YouTubers. She's just amazing. I love the casual vibe that she has. I love how creative her videos are, and one of the series that she started is just ranking like a particular category of products in her collection. So she's done ranking her highlighters, foundations, eyeshadow palettes. I believe also she's ranked like her lip products. So yeah, she's done a lot of those kind of things, and I kind of got inspired and I wanted to do something similar and rank like different categories. And one of the categories that I decided I want to start with is lip products, and I want to specifically just like segment that a little bit and do like bullet lipstick separately and liquid lipsticks separately. So if you guys been watching me and following me on my Instagram stories in the month of September, you would know that September was a liquid lipstick month for me, and it was majorly because I wanted to really be creative and also use all the different liquid lipsticks that I have in my collection, so that it's going to be easier for me to be fair enough and rank all of them. So that's pretty much what we're going to be doing in this video. And I have all my liquid lipsticks right here. I did do a video where I just share all of them with you, but today we're going to be actually ranking them. So I have 7 liquid lipsticks in total, and I will be starting from my least favorite liquid lipstick and talk about my most favorite liquid lipstick in the comment section. Okay, I kind of mixed up what I was trying to say. So basically, I will be starting from my least favorite liquid lipstick to my best liquid lipstick. But before that, I want you to pause this video, and I will leave a list of all of my liquid lipsticks that I own in my collection in the description box, just in case you haven't watched the other video. And what I want you guys to do is that, according to you, I like put yourself in my shoes and just assume that you're me for like 2 minutes, and let me know what you think I would rank these liquid lipsticks according to, like from least favorite to most favorite. I want you to rank all of them and tell me what you think I would rank these as, if you know what I'm saying. I hope I was good enough in describing that. So pause this video right now, go to the description box, check out all of the lipsticks, and then rank them in the comment section for me. And I want to know, I want to read your comments after this video goes live, and I want to see how many of you guys come even close. Now, of course, I'm pretty sure the ranking might not be perfect for most of you, but I want to specifically know if you can guess my favorite liquid lipstick and my least favorite liquid lipstick. That's majorly what I want to see, if you guys are able to guess or not. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this little exercise. And then play the video again, and I will now share with you what my favorite liquid lipsticks are. Like, again, least favorite to most favorite. I feel like this intro is super duper long, and we need to quickly dive right in, and I'll be sharing with you. So, starting with my least favorite liquid lipstick. This is not just the least favorite out of the bunch, but this is actually a liquid lipstick that I'm not super duper fond of, and I feel like I'm somewhere responsible for the same as well. So this is basically a liquid lipstick which was raved about, like absolutely raved about at one point on YouTube, I think like 3 or 4 years back, and that is the Shambor Extreme Wear Transfer Proof Liquid Lipstick. So I have this shade which is like a pink, it's like a mauve pink color, like you can see right here. It's not a frosted glass bottle. It's not a frosted glass bottle, it's just like a plastic tube, and the color is pretty true to what you see. And it had the shade name on a sticker on the bottom. The sticker came off, so I think it is either 461 or 481. I'm not extremely sure, but I will swatch it for you. I know I should not have been wearing like, like a full CC shirt. So yeah, this is what the color looks like, and when you swatch it, it looks very opaque, but when you actually put it on the lips, it is very patchy. And the main reason this is my least favorite liquid lipstick is because it's the only liquid lipstick out of all the liquid lipsticks I have which is the most patchiest, and that's the main reason I'm not fond of this lipstick. It's the patchiness. So if it was not as patchy, I think I would definitely rate it a lot higher. But what I don't like about it is it's a patchy. Secondly, I don't find this to be as long lasting. I feel like after I eat, it kind of starts cracking, comes out weirdly, and I feel like it's because this is one of probably this is probably the oldest lipstick, liquid lipstick that I own. And the reason it's become so old is I think the reason why it's gone bad, and that's the reason why it is so patchy and it does not really apply that well, doesn't really last that well. Because I do remember that when I had just newly got it, I did enjoy using it a lot and I've used it a lot. And at that time, I don't remember having a lot of issues and complaints with it. But yeah, that was that. As of now, I don't like this lipstick at all, but I will try my best to use it as much as I can, probably like mix it in with other lipsticks and make it work somehow, because I don't want to just throw it away. I want to use it and use it up as much as I'm sorry. I just flinged it, it just fell out of my hand and fell on the floor. But yeah, what I was saying is that I want to use it as much as I can and use it up before it goes bad and I have to throw it away. But yeah, this is my least favorite liquid lipstick. Now moving on to my second least favorite. So probably I would say top six, because I have seven in total. So my top six or my bottom two liquid lipstick would be this one right here. Now, one thing I forgot to mention when I started talking about all of them is that I'm rating the formulas. I'm not rating the colors, because I think that's going to be unfair, because obviously I will rate the nudes, the browns, and the terracottas higher, and the reds and the darker burgundy shades I will obviously rate lower in that case. So I'm not going to be rating the colors, I'm only going to be rating the formulations in this video, because color preferences and are definitely like very different from person to person. You might love reds and burgundies and I don't. I love nudes and you might not. In fact, it's a fact, like when it comes to my best friend, she loves reds, bright pinks, not like neon pinks, but like brighter, darker pinks, reds and burgundies a lot more, and she's not a nude lipstick kind of girl at all. So I think rating colors would not really be like an ideal like situation. So I'm going to be rating only the formulation. So even though I absolutely freakingly love this color, and this color is super duper special to me for a lot of reasons, but the formulation I have realized over a period of time is not the most, it's not the best formulation. It's the Sugar Smudge Me Not liquid lipsticks, and these are one of the most drying liquid lipsticks. They start drying and cracking after a point, and it's not ideal whatsoever to wear these lipsticks on their own. You definitely either need a lip balm, but what I personally do is to make sure that it doesn't crack and lasts really really well throughout the days, I actually pair this with a Bullet lipstick. So out of the lipsticks I have in my collection, I pair this with Bella Vase Mocha Spice. So I use that as a base. It's like a moisturizing cream lipstick, and I use that underneath, and then I put on the Sugar Smudge Me Not liquid lipstick in the shade Belle Flare on top of that, and that's how I make it work, and it does work really really well throughout the day. So I have absolutely no complaints. It lasts throughout the day, does not crack, maybe just a little bit here and there, but it's a lot better, and that's how I make this particular one work. But on its own, it's a very drying liquid lipstick. And it's absolutely not recommended by me at all for that particular reason. So yeah, I have this and that's why I make it work. But if you ask me, would I repurchase this? Even though I absolutely love the shade and I want to actually find a dupe for the shade as well, but I don't think I would actually particularly repurchase this lipstick, because then again, I would have to find like, if I buy like a different shade, again, I'll have to find a shade in my collection, or maybe buy like a Bullet cream lipstick that is a similar shade and then just like pair them well together. But yeah, at one point I really loved this lipstick, but I've realized after using it continuously how drying the formulation is, which is why I would totally not recommend it. I do have a Sugar liquid lipstick which I would actually recommend over this and over a lot of lipsticks that I have, and we'll talk about that in a while. But yeah, this one. Moving on, next is the Avon Dare to Be Bare lipstick. Like Dare to Be Bare is the shade, This is from the Avon MAC Liquid Lip Lacquer Matte range, and this is my top 3 or my bottom, sorry, top 5 or bottom 3, however you want to say it, lipstick. And it's basically, just like the name suggests, it's a liquid lip, but it's a lacquer. So it's not really a liquid lipstick which dries out completely. It's more of like a moussey formulation, and that is actually like a great thing about this lipstick. It is very comfortable, so if you have more dry lips, if your lips are chapped always and you have very dry lips in general, this is going to be a great liquid lipstick for you. The color in particularly is again a little bit more light. I wish it had a little bit more brown to it, and it was a little bit deeper. It would have been a great color for my complexion, but again, this is something which I have to mix in with a darker, deeper nude to make it work. Again, this is one of the lipsticks which I either mix in with Bella Vasya Mocha Spice, or I mix it in with Caramel Toffee, depending on the kind of look I'm going for. If I'm going for a more peachy look, I'll mix it with Lakme Caramel Toffee, and I feel like it looks a lot better. If I'm going for a more like strictly nude, like a warm nude kind of a look, then I would mix it in Bella Vasya Mocha Spice. So again, depending, but again, like I mentioned, I'm not rating this based on color. I'm strictly keeping the formulations in mind, and the reason I'm rating this as fifth is because it's a very, very nice, comfortable formulation, and that's something I really love about this, since it doesn't like dry out completely, like doesn't dry on the lips completely. But it's something which I feel like is not very, very long lasting, and after you have a meal or something like that, it's going to fade unevenly, and that's something I'm not particularly fond of. There are liquid lipsticks which are very, very comfortable on the lips, but they still last very, very well throughout the day. And I definitely prefer a formulation like that over this one. So that's the reason why I would not highly, highly, highly recommend this. They also don't have a lot of shades in the range, which is why I actually picked up this one to try out. So yeah, that's also like kind of a con. So yeah, we have that as the fifth. Moving on, next is the lipstick which is a lot better than the Sugar Sponge Me Not liquid lipstick. This is again by Sugar. It's the Sugar Suede Secret Matte Lip Color, and I have it in the shade Felt Fawn. Now this is a lipstick which I remember back in the day when this was new to my collection, and I already had the Sugar Sponge Me Not liquid lipstick. I preferred that a lot over this, but now the tables have turned. After using it continuously, I have realized how much better the formulation of this is, because it does take a little while to dry out, but eventually it dries out completely. And once it dries out completely, it lasts so, so well throughout the day. But it's such a comfortable formulation. It lasts beautifully throughout the day on its own. I don't need to pair this shade, or I feel like the formulation in general also does not need to be paired with any other lipstick. On its own, it's beautiful. It's absolutely perfect. It's very comfortable on the lips. It lasts very well throughout the day. I don't really have anything bad to say about this lipstick at all. And that's something that's the reason why I'm pairing this as my top 4. And yeah, that is what I had to share about this particular lipstick. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Now moving on to my top 3. This is the Faces All Time Pro Long Stay Liquid Matte Lipstick. Now this is very different compared to all the other lipsticks that I have in my collection. It is a liquid, but it has some sort of a cream finish to it. It's not a moussey creamy lipstick. It's like if a liquid lipstick and a cream moussey liquid lipstick had a child. It's something like that. When you apply it, it feels a little bit more softer, creamier, and moussier. But it dries pretty much instantly, and it becomes like just like a liquid lipstick, like a regular liquid lipstick. It's just absolutely amazing. Again, it's one that lasts very, very well throughout the day on its own. It does not need to be paired with any other liquid lipstick. The only reason I use a lip liner with this is because it's a darker shade. So while applying, it looks a lot more like evenly finished when it's paired with a lip liner. But otherwise, like I just use a lip liner to like outline my lips. I don't fill in with the lip liner. So that's again something I want to mention. And it lasts very, very well throughout the day. It's very comfortable. I definitely want to actually get more shades in this line, because again, and also I want to get more shades in the Suede Secret Matte Lip Color as well, because since this is like a cool toned grayish, it's like a grayish literally. It's that kind of a shade. It's not something that can be worn. Can you believe that? But yeah, since it's like a grayish, like a brown gray kind of a shade, it's not something I'm able to wear very often, like on an every single day basis, which is why I want to get more shades in the Sugar Suede Secret Matte Lip Color and also the Faces All Time Pro, what is this called? Long Stay Liquid Matte Lipstick. I want to get more shades in both of these. By the way, this is what the Sugar Suede Secret Matte Lip Color looks like. So yeah, it's not a shade that you can wear very often, but yeah, I do want to get more shades in both these ranges so then I can wear them more often. But yeah, this is my top 4, this is my top 3. Now moving on to my top 2, and I know it's going to sound very funny when I say that my top 2 liquid lipsticks are the same formulation, but they are 2 separate shades. Now, 5 minutes back, I just said that I'm not going to be rating these lipstick based on shades, and I'm still telling you the same thing. I'm not rating these liquid lipsticks based on the shade, but I feel like this formulation has a little bit of maybe difference, and I can say inconsistencies. Actually, I don't think inconsistencies is the right word, but I feel like different lipsticks last differently on the lips in terms of how smoothly they apply or how well they last throughout the day, and that's the reason why I'm saying that both of these are slightly different. Now, it is possible that the other lipsticks, the other formulations I talk about, have spoken about already, might also have a similar issue. But with all of these formulations, I've tried out only one lipstick in like every range. So unless and until I don't try a different shade, I can't tell. But with this liquid lipstick formulation, which is the Pat Retro Matte Glosses, I have tried out 2 of the shades, which is why I can tell you that the way they apply and the way they last are not the exact same, which is why I have a top 2 and then I have the best. Top 2 is Soza, which is a more coral pink sort of a color. You can see right here. I kind of messed up my entire hand while swatching the Suede Secret Matte Lip Color, which is why I can't swatch these 2 on my hands. But yeah, I will try and show you as best as I can. But this is the shade Soza, which is like a pink coral sort of a shade, and this is the top 2. Now, the reason I rated this a little bit lesser than this, I would say, is because I feel like when I'm applying this lipstick, if I apply it on its own, it does not look as pretty, but when I mix it in with Strawberry Daiquiri by NYX, it looks a lot more prettier and it lasts very, very well throughout the day. On the other hand, the Pack Retro Matte Gloss in the shade Teddy Bear, when I use it on its own, it lasts perfectly, just like this plus NYX Strawberry Daiquiri does. So I feel like this needs a little bit more work, but Pack Teddy Bear, it's perfect on its own. It does not need to be paired with anything else. It applies very, very smoothly, lasts very, very long throughout the day. It's comfortable, it's non-drying, and lasts extremely, extremely, extremely well throughout the day. I literally have no con, absolutely no con, when it comes to the Pat Retro Matte Glosses, and that's the reason why they are rated as my top liquid lipstick out of all the liquid lipsticks that I have in my collection. So yeah, that was pretty much it for this video. I feel like this video is a lot longer than what I expected it to be, so I'm not gonna make it any longer, and I just want to quickly sign off by saying that if you enjoyed watching this video and you would like to watch more such videos from me, then definitely do subscribe to my channel, hit on the bell button so that way you'll get to know every single time I post a new video. Follow me on my Instagram and I will leave a link to all these lipsticks, like all the formulations, not really the particular shades, but the formulations in the description box. So just in case you're interested in checking them out, you can do so. And again, I'm leaving my Instagram handle, so in case you're interested in following me on my Instagram, you can definitely do so. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Also, let me know if you would like me to do more such ranking videos, because personally, I really, really enjoyed the entire process of doing this. And if there's a particular category you might rank first than others, then definitely leave that also in the comment section down below. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Until next time, bye. Bye bye.